So let me open my Palm Drop application. So let's design the circuit diagram of the stable mode by using any 555 timer IC. Then just click the three dot icon, then just click the new icon, then just clicking yes. Then we have three options about the three size of the schematic diagram. So let's use the small one. So now let's click the key icon. Then you can click on the IC symbol. The application allows you to import and export any component symbol or circuit diagram. Then you can easily to access to those component or circuit diagram. In the end of my video, I will show you how to import and export. So just stop and hold on the screen and move the two fingers outward to zoom out. To zoom in, just move inward. To drag down the IC symbol, just click any on the top of the screen as a first corner of the IC. Then click on the bottom of the screen as the second corner of the IC. Then let's create the notch of the IC. Just follow the instruction. Click on the first point, then click at the second point. The notch of the IC is used to indicate the first pin of the IC. Since in this circuit designing we use any 555 timer IC with a total of 8 pin, then let's create the pin of the IC by clicking the key icon. So let's select or choosing the cross logo line. So just clicking on the first pin of the IC, then click again at the second pin of the IC, click again at pin 3 and pin 4, then click again at pin 8 of the IC, followed by click on pin 7, then click on a pin 6, and followed by a pin 5. Then click on the key icon. Then you can click the alphabet logo to pop up the label mode and to write the number pin of the IC. Then to access the keyboard, just click on the label blank in the label mode. I just click the logo number, then click the number 1, then just click done and click OK. Then drag it down at pin 1 again, to type or writing the PIN number 2, just click on the checking icon. Then, just click on the label mode to access the keyboard. Then, just click the logo number and click number 2. Then, just click on done. And then, just click on OK to drag it down, just clicking on PIN 2. Then, just keeping the process again and again until those number of the PIN will be written on the top of the IC. Just tap and hold on the screen. Then you can move the screen in any direction. Then, just click again the key icon. Then, just clicking on the crossline logo. And then, let's create the draw line. To create the draw line, just click at the end of the PIN 2. Then again, just click at the end of the line. Then click again at the end of the line. Then just click on the arrow point. Then click again at the end of the line. And to extend the line, just click at the arrow point. To extend again the line, just click at the end point of the line. Then connect to pin 6. Then at this time, we need to connect both pin 4 and 8. So just click the key logo icon, then click the dash line, then just click at the end of the line at pin 4. Then click at any point to extend the line. Then, just click the key icon and click the cross line logo. Then click at the end of the dash line and click at any point to extend the line. Then click at the end of the new line. And then click again at any point to extend the new line. Then click again at the end of the new line, and to extend, just click at any point. As you can see, the line will be exceeded. So just click the undo and click again at the end point of the line, then click at any point to extend the line, then connect to pin 8. Again, click the key icon, then click the resistor symbol, then drag it down as long as the resistor inside the red box, you can move in any direction. Then just click the checking icon to remove the red box. Then just click again the key icon and click the resistor. Then drag it down and connect to the first resistor. Then click the ticking icon. Then, click again the key icon and click the capacitor, then drag it down and click the ticking icon. Then click again the key logo and click the cross logo, then connect pin 7 to the center of the 2 resistor and connect the capacitor. Then connect the capacitor to pin 6. Then click again the key icon and click the ground symbol, then drag it down to the capacitor, then click the checking icon. Then again, you can click the key icon, then click the ground symbol and drag it down at pin 1. Then click the checking icon. Then again, click the key icon, then click the resistor, drag it down, then click the rotation to rotate the resistor, then click the checking icon. Click the key logo, then click the dash line, and click at pin 3, then connect to the resistor, and click again the key logo, then just click the LED, then drag it down and connect to the resistor, and click the checking icon, then click the key icon again, and click the ground symbol, then drag it down and connect to the LED, then click the checking icon. Then you can click again the key icon, then click the alphabet logo and click on the label blank and write 1 kilo ohms resistor, then click done. Then click OK, then drag it down on the second resistor, then just click the checking icon and click on the label blank, then type 10 kilo ohms resistor, then click done. And click OK, then drag it down at the first resistor. Then click again the checking icon and click on the label blank. Then type 104 capacitor. Then click done and click OK. Then drag it down to the capacitor. Then just click again on the checking icon and click on the label blank. Then entering the value of the resistor, which is 330 ohms. Resistor, then just click done, then click OK, drag it down on the resistor, then click again the checking icon and click on the label blank, then just type the LED, then click done. and click OK. Drag it down to the lid. Then again, click the checking icon. Then click on the label blank. Then type NE555 timer IC. Then click done. And click OK. Then drag it down on the top of the IC. The circuit is almost done. Then just click again the key icon. Then scroll down and click the battery symbol. Then drag it down and click the rotation icon. Then just click the flip size icon to interchange the polarity of the battery. Then just click the checking icon. Then click the key icon again and click the cross logo line. Then just click on the positive side of the battery and connect to pin 8. Then click the key icon again and click ground, drag it down and connect to the negative side of the battery. Then just click on the checking icon. Now the circuit is done. Now let me share how to import and export any component or circuit diagram, at the same time how to delete, how to move the component, and copy paste. So let's start. So let's try this circuit diagram to import and to export. Then just click the black icon and click select and copy block. Then click from the first corner and followed at the second corner. Then just click checking icon. Then click again the black icon and click the export block. Then just type on the label blank. Let's say just type a stable circuit export. Then just click OK. Then let's try to import the circuit diagram. To import the circuit diagram, let's clear first the circuit diagram. Then click again the black icon and click the black import. Then just click the stable circuit black export. Then just tap on destination and then just click the checking icon. Now let's remove the circuit diagram and let's click the three dot icon. Then click the clear icon and click yes. Then click again the key icon. This is another example of the import and export circuit. So let's click the NPN transistor, then drag it down, click the checking icon, then let's zoom out, then click the black icon and click select and copy block. Then just click from the first corner to the second corner. Then checking icon. Then again, click the black icon and select the export block. Then click on the blank. Then just type the NPN export. And just click the done. And click OK. Now, let's go back to the three dot icon. Then click the clear icon and click OK. Then click again the black icon and click the export block. Then just select the NPN export block. Click the checking icon. That is how to export and import. This time, I will show you how to delete the components. Just click again the black icon, then select the delete. Then click from the first corner, then from the second corner, and click the checking icon. Then the component is deleted. And then select the black icon and click select and copy block. Then select the first corner and the second corner. Then click the checking icon. Click again the black icon and click paste block. Then just click the checking icon. To duplicate again the components, just keep repeating, clicking the checking icon. Then, just stop on destination. So, thanks again for watching my video tutorial.